Kina from Bougainville, and today I'm going to show you how to make a traditional dish from Buka called Kikiono Poso. Kikiono Poso basically in Buka dialect means tapioc and banana. So yep, that's what we're going to look at, the process of how to make the traditional dish from Buka called Kikiono Poso. And here we have cassava. Cassava here is taken from the garden. That's the root of the cassava. Will be peeled off, scraped, and its meat will be extracted and used. To go with it will be this banana here. Ripe banana will be mixed with the cassava, as well as coconuts. Coconuts is one of the main ingredient as well that will go with the tapioc, the banana, and will produce this traditional dish of Kikiono Poso. Now washing the cassava, ready for scraping. As you can see, she is scraping the cassava. She's scraping it using a flat sheet of iron that is homemade. So this is Eugene. Eugene is helping out Lucy scraping the coconut for the Kikiono Poso. That's the coconut here. So they're going to squeeze it, milk out the cream in preparation, and the milk will be mixed with the cassava and banana, and then it will be ready for the mumu. Okay, this is the scraped cassava or tapioc, and as you can see as well, this is the scraped coconut. So for now, we will squeeze the cassava to get rid of some of the excessive waters that is inside, and for the coconut, we will milk it and we'll extract the milk, the cream, and it will be put together with the cassava and the banana. Now here Lucy is squeezing the cassava, getting rid of the excessive water. And she is using a shade cloth. After squeezing the cassava, Lucy is now spreading the dried cassava in the dish. Yes, she's just spreading it out, preparing it. Here they're adding water into the coconut. Lucy is now getting the coconut, scraped coconut, putting it into strainer here, and we'll be squeezing it straight into the cassava. All right, now she's mixing the cream with the cassava, and when the coconut is being absorbed by the cassava goes soft, really soft when it absorbs the cream, and that's gonna be really good for the cassava banana pudding. Alright, now they are peeling the ripe bananas, peeling off the skin, and these ripe bananas, after peeling it off, they will be mixing it with the cassava. and the cream, coconut cream. Now Lucy is baking, getting the cassava with the coconut cream and placing it into the leaf here. The leaf is from the bush cane, taken from the bush. She's put the first layer of cassava with the coconut cream first on the leaf, and then she'll be adding the banana on top of it. Yes, so the banana will stay in between the cassava. So after placing the banana there, she'll put some more cassava on top. So when it gets cooked, you'll see that the banana will be in the center of the pudding. And when you eat it, it will be so delicious. So that's the Kikiono Poso, traditional dish from Buka. Now she has to make sure to tie the knot properly so that it doesn't get loose. Okay, this is the hot stone of Mumu, a hot pit. Yes, as you can see down at the base, there's stones. Now Lucy's making up the fire, and when it's lit, it will heat up the stones underneath there, and she'll put some more firewood on top and place more stones on top. And yep, that's the mumu, the hot stone mumu. Lucy is now placing the Kikiono Poso onto the stone pit. As you can see, it's quite hot, and yes, she's placing it there, and then we'll put more the stones on top. As you can see, the stones on the side, she will place it on top, and we'll cover it with banana leaves, and we'll leave it. Now that's the final bit. She's covering up the mumu hot stones with banana leaves. We are checking the Kikiono Poso. She's removing it, as you can see. These are the copra bags that were put on top to cover the mumu. This is Hadesa, and she'll be showing us how the Kikiono Poso turned out. So Hadesa, please, can you open up the Kikiono Poso? So Sasa, show it to us, the Kikiono Poso. Yes, that's it. Then you break it in half. Yes, the red part inside, in the middle, that's the banana, the ripe bananas that were placed in between the cassava. So that's the Kikiono Poso. Very delicious.